Thanks, Gregory, and hi, everybody. I am François Botin. I work at the CA, and I would thank the organizer to giving us the opportunity to present the ATDEP code, which is developed with Johan Boucher. So ATDEP is the temperature dependent effective potential in Abinet. This is a Fortran code, and this code is available in the Abinet package. And this code allows us to obtain lattice dynamics, including in anharmonicity. There are two approximations when we are interested in lattice dynamics. The first one is the harmonic approximation. And in this case, there is no temperature dependency except the one through the filling of the energy levels using the Bose-Einstein statistic. If you want to go beyond, you can use the quasi-harmonic approximation, and you obtain the thermal expansion. And in this case, the phonon frequencies implicitly depend on the temperature through the variation of the volume. And all these calculations can be performed using finite differences or the more elegant density functional perturbation theory. The quasi-harmonic approximation gives good results in numerous cases, except when the phonon frequencies evolve at constant volume. That is to say, in the quasi-harmonic approximation, at constant volume, you can't have any variation of the phonon frequencies as a function of temperature. So in order to go beyond and to capture such anharmonic effects, you have to take the temperature effect explicitly. This can be done using molecular dynamic simulations or Monte Carlo calculations. So the main quantity here is the phonon frequencies, and we want to have the explicit temperature dependency of these phonon frequencies. And in this case, we can also obtain the explicit temperature dependencies of other properties, such as the elastic properties, which can be computed as the slope of the phonon acoustic branches, or the dynamic stability, which allows to understand the stability of a material as a function of the temperature. And this is related to the variation of the phonon frequencies as a function of temperature. And the phonon spectrum is used to compute the phonon density of states and also to obtain thermodynamic properties such as the internal energy, heat capacity, free energy, entropy, and you can also compute the total free energy of your system. And last but not least, you can also compute the transport properties, such as the thermal conductivity, which depends on the heat capacity, group velocities, and lifetime. So in all these quantities, depends on the phonon frequencies or its derivatives, but in fact, depend on the Quay quantity, which is the interatomic force constant. And as an example, I show here the thermal expansion, and this quantity depends on the specific heat, which depends on the phonon density of states, that is to say, on the second order interatomic force constant. And it's also the case for the bulk modulus, which is a linear combination of the elastic constants. And these ones can be computed using the second order interatomic force constant. You have also in this equation the Greenhausen parameter. And in this case, you have the third order interatomic force constant. So, in fact, the aim is to compute here the interatomic force constant at the first, second, third, and fourth order. So if you consider the expansion of the potential energy around equilibrium as a function of the atomic displacement U, you have the first, second, third, and fourth order interatomic force constant. in this equation. And if you compute the gradient, you obtain the forces. And if you consider only the second order term, you have a linear relation between the forces and the atomic displacement. And this is the second order interatomic force constant. But if you consider third order and fourth order, this equation is no longer linear with respect to the atomic displacement, and you have nonlinear terms. But this equation can be rewritten in a linear formulation. That is to say, you can put all the nonlinearities inside a function of the atomic displacement, and you have here all the EFC coefficients. So now you have a linear equation, and if you perform ab initio molecular dynamic simulation, you can store all the forces and the atomic displacement for all the time step. And if you put all this data in the previous equation, you obtain a system of equations with the ab initio forces and displacements, and you want to compute the EFC coefficients here at the first, second, third, and fourth order. And this system of equations can be solved using a least square method, and the solution is just by reverting the system of equation, and you obtain here the EFC coefficient. So this is the TDEP method proposed by Hellman and implemented in the ABINIT code by Johan Boucher and me. So, but this method now is not really tractable because the EFC coefficients are really numerous. And in fact, you can have you have to perform ab initio molecular dynamics simulations, which are very long with tens of thousands time steps, if you want to compute such a large number of EFC coefficients. So you have to reduce them, and using invariances such as translation, the acoustic sum rule, or rotation invariances, symmetries of the crystal, symmetries of the dynamical matrix, selective tensor, and so on, you can reduce strongly the number of EFC coefficients. For example, for 100 atoms in your supercell, at the second order, you have 90,000 coefficients, and you can reduce them to around 20. At the third order, you have in fact 27 millions of EFC coefficients, and you can reduce them to 100, 2, or 300 coefficients. So to summarize, here you want to compute the EFC coefficients at the second, third, and fourth order here, which are in the middle, and you have the forces and the atomic displacements coming from an ab initio molecular dynamics simulations. And you rewrite the system of equation, and you can compute all the EFC coefficients at the second, third, and fourth order. You can inverse this system of equation and obtain these EFC coefficients. This is the mathematical procedure for TDEP. But now, what is the physical meaning of TDEP? So now, if you consider an expansion up to the fourth order, the meaning of TDEP is that if you cut at the second order, in fact, you recast all the orders beyond the second order into the second order one. So in fact, in this case, the EFC are no longer constant as a function of temperature, but depend now, explicitly depend on the temperature. And all the quantities obtained using the EFCs now depend explicitly from the temperature. And you can do the same job if you cut at the fourth order, you have the second, third, and fourth order EFCs now depending on the temperature explicitly. And at the fourth order, you obtain, in this case, so this is a crude picture, not a real picture of TDEP, but now, so you have at the second order sometimes, which is not does not represent the correct potential energy, but at the fourth order, the representation is better, and that's we can see if we plot the forces for the TDEP at the second or third order with respect to the forces computed at the using ab initio molecular dynamics. And you can see that the results is better when you include higher order in the development, in the expansion. Now, a few examples. The first one is the BCC phase of zirconium. This one is unstable at room temperature and zero GPA. And the BCC phase, in fact, is stabilized when you increase the temperature or the pressure. And that's we obtain if we compute the phonon spectrum. The dot black lines here is the calculation of the phonon spectrum at room temperature and zero GPA. And there are several soft modes in the phonon spectrum. And if you increase the temperature, you obtain the black solid lines. And you can see that in this case, there is no longer soft mode in the phonon spectrum. And this means that the BCC phase of zirconium is now dynamically stable. And you obtain the same thing if you increase the pressure. Another example is the alpha phase of uranium. In this case, we have computed this phonon spectrum with Johann Boucher 6 years ago, and we compare, so with TDEP, and we compare it to the experiments for room temperature. The agreement is really good. And one interesting thing is the behavior of the phonon modes. This mode as a function of temperature. In TDEP, we obtain that this mode decreases as a function of temperature, as it is in experiments. But using the DFPG in the quasi-harmonic approximation, we obtain that, in fact, this mode increases. And this is a clear failure of the quasi-harmonic approximation. And in addition, we also obtain a correct variation of the bulk modulus with respect to the temperature using TDEP, and it was not the case using the quasi-harmonic approximation. The alpha phase of uranium is stable at room temperature, but if you increase the temperature and just below the melting curve, you obtain another phase, which is the BCC phase of uranium. And as it was for the BCC phase of zirconium, this one is unstable at 0K. Here you have the phonon spectrum computed using DFPG, and you see that there are several soft modes in the phonon spectrum. And if you increase the temperature, this crystal, this BCC phase is stabilized, but is only dynamically stabilized. If you want to see if this phase is thermodynamically stable, you have to compute the free energy of the alpha and gamma phase for several temperature and pressure and compare them together. And you obtain, as a function of temperature and pressure, the following transition line, the red solid line here. And this transition line is in good agreement with the experimental one. Another interesting system is the fast transition between the B1 and B2 phases of the magnesium oxide. And there are numerous calculations about this line transition as a function of temperature and pressure, and with different techniques and approximation. And if the differences are not large at low temperature, the spread is very large at high temperature. So we compute this line transition using TDEP here, and we see that we are in good agreement with the calculation using the virtual, the velocity autocorrelation function, which is a kind of reference here in this for this calculation. In addition, we also obtain the variation of the Greenhausen parameter with respect to the temperature, which is impossible in the quasi-harmonic approximation. There is no variation of the frequencies as a function of temperature at constant volume. So you can't have any also variation of the Greenhausen parameter, the derivative of the phonon frequencies. And here you can see that the for the B2 phi phase, the blue circle at 2000 K and 8000 K, you have a variation as of the Greenhausen parameter as a function of temperature and at constant volume. The same case for the B1 phase. So it's an interesting result. So how to run TDEP in Abinet? As usual, you need three lines in your input files. The first one has all the variables needed. The second file has the trajectory in NetCDF format or ASCII format. And the third one is a root for the output file. And in fact, you have many output files in ATDEP. You have a main input file where you have the two second order interatomic force constant, third order, fourth order interatomic force constant, but also the elastic tensor, moduli, the bulk and shear moduli, the by temperature, and also many other files, such as the phonon density of states, the frequencies, the eigenvector, the DB file, thermodynamical data, and so on. And if you are at the third and fourth order, you also have the Greenhausen parameter, the thermal expansion, the thermal pressure, the longitudinal and transversal velocities, the isentropic bulk modulus. And since the last meeting 2 years ago, what's new in TDEP, with Johan Boucher, we have implemented the fourth order interatomic force constant, also the long range electrostatic interaction and alloy description using the virtual crystal approximation. Also the possibility to have different weights for different configurations as it is used in the MLACS method of Alois Castellano, and also we have parallelized over configuration, and the execution of the TDEP code needs only a few seconds or tens of seconds. You have also created.
Can you conclude?
Yes, it's my last slide. We have created a series of tests for TDEP with 40 tests for the beginners. And also improve the documentation with topic, input variables, user guide, and also a new tutorial. And here you can see all these web pages. And this is my last slide. And I thank you for your attention.
Okay, thank you, François. We have time just for one question. So there is a question in the chat of Mathieu. Are there long-range corrections and separation for the higher order force constants?
Long-range and short-range separation?
Yes, for the higher order.
For the electrostatic contribution? For the long-range electrostatic contribution?
Yeah, for the harmonic case, you subtract the LOTO splitting parts. Do you do the same for the third order and fourth order cases?
No. We only did that for second order, but we plan to do that for the third and the fourth order.
And Xavier asks if you do the thermal conductivity as well. I think yes.
No. The conductivity now is not really implemented. We only have put all the stuff to do that, but the conductivity is not yet really implemented. Yeah.